300 Plus was unofficially on sale in a few states for the past 6 months. But now the car has officially been launched in the whole of India, starting at Rs 9.69 lakhs. The Mahindra TUV300 Plus is basically a longer version of the standard TUV300 and gets certain modifications at its rear end. The SUV comes powered by an M-Hawk 120 HP 2.2-litre diesel engine and is mated to a 6-speed manual gearbox instead of the 5-speed one that we see in the standard TUV300. On the inside, features include vinyl seat upholstery, all-back interiors, a 9-seater configuration with fold-up, side-facing third-row seats, power steering with tilt, 4 power windows, central locking, an AC with a heater, internally adjustable wing mirrors, and 2 12V charging sockets. Volvo is planning to launch the smaller XC40 SUV in India, and as we have come to know, the launch may happen on 4th July. Booking for the XC40 is now open and it can be booked by paying an amount as high as Rs 5 lakh. The XC40 is the first Volvo car in India to be built on the compact modular architecture. For now, the XC40 will be offered in a single, fully loaded R-Design variant with a 2-litre 4-cylinder diesel engine, which gives out 190 HP of peak power and 400 Nm of peak torque. Power from the engine is sent to all the wheels via an 8-speed automatic transmission. Depending on the response, Volvo would decide on introducing a petrol version in future. Features of the Volvo XC40 include wireless mobile phone charging, a 750 watts 12-speaker Harman Kardon sound system, 19-inch wheels, powered tailgate, and heated front and rear seats. The sporty R-Design trim also features a dual-tone interior and 9-inch touchscreen infotainment system with Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. A few images doing the rounds on the web seems to suggest that Jeep will launch the updated Renegade sometime later this year. Changes to the Jeep Renegade facelift would include both design and interior changes. A new engine may also be added. Exterior changes would include revised LED daytime running lights and other such subtle tweaks, while the car's rugged and retro styling, typical of Jeep, will be carried with the new model. On the inside, a larger infotainment system with touchscreen controls will be added. The refreshed Renegade is likely to come with a 2-litre 4-cylinder turbo petrol engine with a 48V mild hybrid system. Most likely date for the launch of the new Renegade is September 2018. Porsche has launched the all-new Cayenne Turbo in India starting at Rs 1.92 crore. Booking for the SUV is already open and the car would be made available in 2 distinct variants, standard and e-hybrid. The Cayenne Turbo is powered by a 550 HP 4-litre petrol V8 and has a torque figure of 770 Nm. It can gallop from 0 to 100 km per hour in just 4.1 seconds with a top speed of 286 km per hour. Design-wise, the Turbo is similar to its predecessor, but weighs 65 kg lighter because of extensive use of aluminium in its body. On the inside, you get things like voice control and touchscreen infotainment system. After reports of delay, Nissan seems getting ready to launch the Kicks in India in the coming months. The Nissan Kicks was designed for emerging markets and was first launched in Brazil in May 2016. In the international market, the Kicks is underpinned by Nissan's V platform. Incidentally, the Nissan Sunny and Micra also uses this platform. It is being speculated that the Indian version, however, will be underpinned by the Dacia's BO Logan platform, which is already utilized by the Nissan Terrano, Renault Duster and Renault Captur. As far as engines are concerned, the Kicks will carry the same engine options as the Renault Captur, 1.5-litre H4-litre petrol and 1.5-litre KNK diesel. Further details will be revealed in the coming days. Hyundai has launched its i20 CVT in India priced between 7.04 and 8.16 lakhs. As far as changes are concerned, there are basically no changes made into these cars except the addition of a CVT automatic transmission, and because of this new transmission, the new i20 is almost 1 lakh dearer compared to the manual transmission version. But even with this price increase, the i20 is cheaper compared to its primary competitors, the Honda Jazz and Maruti Baleno. Kia has revealed the updated Sportage SUV. The new Sportage gets a new EcoDynamics Plus model, which comes with a 48-volt lithium-ion battery. Other than that, the car has a 2-liter diesel engine, which produces 134 HP of peak power. The petrol version will carry the existing 1.6-liter turbocharged unit. In Europe, the new EcoDynamics Plus will sit above the 1.6-litre diesel CRDI, replacing the 1.7-litre petrol. Design features include modified headlights and bumpers. Top spec variants will get LED fog lamps and sportier detailing. On the inside, features include 7-inch touchscreen infotainment system as standard, with an 8-inch system available as an option, and smart cruise control, etc. Lexus has launched the petrol-powered LX570 in India, starting at ₹2.33 crore. So far, only the diesel-powered car was available. The petrol variant of the LX570 gets its power from a 5.7-litre V8 engine, which makes 367 HP of peak power and 530 Nm of peak torque. The engine is mated to an 8-speed automatic transmission, which sends power to all the four wheels. Here it must be noted that the diesel variant has 6-speed transmission. With all this power, the LX570 zooms to 100 km per hour in just 7.7 seconds, which makes it almost a second quicker than the 450D. No design and feature changes can be seen in the 570, and it is identical to the 450D in these aspects. The X8, touted to be BMW's most expensive SUV, will be unveiled in 2020. When launched, it will take on the likes of Bentley Bentayga, Audi Q8, Lamborghini Urus and Rolls-Royce Cullinan. The X8 would be a 5-seater SUV and will be focused more on delivering luxury rather than anything else. It is highly likely that the X8 would employ a hybrid platform. It will be a mix between BMW CLAR architecture and Rolls-Royce aluminium space frame, which underpins the new Cullinan. The powertrain would either be a powerful gasoline engine from the 7x8 series or a hybrid drivetrain. The petrol motor would be the 6.6 litre V12 from the 7 series with more than 600 bhp on tap. The X-Drive will be standard.